Tonight is about accepting that the other exists and that should have the right to narrate him or herself as they wish, and not to be harassed, and to choose the discursive approach without being physically or verbally attacked, or even slaughtered because they think differently, want to act differently, and have a different agenda. King of the Sands is about the construction of political historical reality that is not in the same line of the dominant and ruling ideology currently in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. In fact, if anything, it is about the other, who, to some extent, has struggled to spread their ideas and positions. It is also about refusing to be an underground cinema, but rather an agenda setter. It is about the necessity of mainstreaming alternative cinema and choosing art cinema. Without further ado, I'd like you, ladies and gentlemen, to watch the trailer of King of the Sands at the moment. Thank you.
With this sword and this holy Quran, you will gain back your grandfather's reign of Najd.
Riyadh and Najd are ours! Either we will take it back, or we die. Allahu Akbar!
What's next? Raid Hael, destroy Shuma and the Rashid family.
I want you to accept a convert to Islam. Even in the name only, without practice.
Sir, I am ready for Islam.
Pay homage to my son Abdulaziz. He is a good omen, and God supported him to conquer Riyadh in order to relieve all Muslims from the tyranny of al-Rashid.
We pay homage abiding by the laws of God and His messenger.
La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah.
You should be happy. By the law of God, I choose you to be mine. I am Abdulaziz Al Saud, Sultan of Najd.
ما شفت بالحياة خود مثلها.
He conquered Riyadh with 60 of his men. He also slew Bin Ajlan. Abdulaziz has God on his side.
He came to Najd with the slogan of monotheism. It is the same slogan of our blessed Sheikh Abdul Rahman bin Abdul Wahhab al-Tamimi. Muslims are obliged to stand by his side. It is your obligation.
King of the Sands, an epic story about the rise of a kingdom.
You must must have noticed that we're talking about a grand production. Tonight, on your behalf, I would like to welcome the internationally renowned Italian guest star who plays the role of the old King Abdulaziz, and he's here with us. Please welcome Fabio Testi. We're also delighted to have with us tonight the actor who plays a crucial role between the emerging kingdom at the time and Imperial Britain. You've just seen him. Please welcome Bill Fellows, or the convert Abdullah. And last, and not least, and before we start our debate, I am not going to praise him because I think that all you need is just to go to the new media in order to know who Najdat Anzour is. Without any censorship whatsoever, anyone can ask any question. This, of course, doesn't mean that anyone is going to answer, but you definitely are allowed to ask whatever you wish to whoever. But perhaps before that, we'll just ask you just a little. You've just arrived from Italy this morning. How come you've just acted or decided to act in a film about Arabs in English, you Italian man?
I think it's, I'm like a doctor, you know. If somebody need to be good, I'm a doctor, and if you need something to do well, I'm there. I'm ready to do whatever you need it. And the first time in my life I did a role named the King role. The role is very important role. For an actor, I think everybody would like to make a role like this. I think it'll be in the history of the cinema. It was many years ago to work with Najdat and have this opportunity. And even if my role is so small, it's a little role, of course. I hope next time I'll be a big role. Thank you very much.
You're a bigger king. You are already. Bill, just one quick question. You are British, and I'll slightly just tell you that Britain is, or to be accurate, Imperial Britain is playing a very interesting role. You are the John Philby the Great, who has got all the movers and shakers in Saudi Arabia in his hands. How did you feel as a new British talking or acting the role of an old British man?
Well, first of all, I would just say what Fabio just said, you know, you're an actor, so you play roles, but when Najdat offered me the part, I knew nothing about this character at all, because in Britain we weren't taught. I've never been taught about John Philby. We know about his son, who became a Russian spy, Kim Philby, but I knew nothing about him at all. So it was an honour. It was an honour to be part of I think a great project, and to work with Najdat. I obviously looked him up on Google, found out about him, and I admire him, and I wanted to work with him because I think he's brave, and I like that.
Thank you. Well, Najdat, would you like to say something or to comment on that? How was it to work with them, actually?
Yeah, they are great actors, and it's a great honor to be with them. It's okay.
Okay. So, perhaps you should take all. The floor is yours. And, well, the first question, the princess, please.
Just why now? Not before. I think, you know, because it's a very historical and we are going through a very critical period of geographical dispute. So it must seem very funny if I come up with a movie saying Al-Assad. So just simply, why now? Thank you.
I work on this project for 2 years. Before the chaos came to the Middle East. it's nothing to do with the situation now or the problems in the Middle East. I prepared for this project for since 2 years, and it came suddenly with this, what happened now in the Middle East. So nothing to do for sure with anything else. But I think we need this kind of subjects to release it on the screen, on the, especially in the big screen, and especially outside the Arab world, in Europe and in America, everywhere. Because in Arab world, they can buy this film, they can stop this film, they can do whatever to change the idea of the film, or maybe to change some scenes from the film. But outside, I feel better, that feel there is more freedom to do such kind of this, such kind of subjects, very sensitive subjects.
Are you a fan of this character, or are you a foe?
I love this character. He is controversial and it's dramatic, and there is a lot of drama in this in his history. So I like it.
So you are fascinated by the rise of the King of the Sand. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Karam Nahma from Middle East Online. It's my question to Mr. Anzour. You started the film before Arabic Spring, and now you talk about relationship with your film and what happened in your country and Saudi Arabia. And another question, what relationship between a Rashid family and the film? Do you funding the film? Thank you.
You can ask her the question for
okay,
her.
Okay, hang on a minute. We've got here the princess of Al Rashid, so perhaps she would like to answer. But anyway, please.
Nothing to do with the sponsoring this. I sponsored for myself. I put everything I have up and down. Nobody sponsored this film. This is first guy. And nothing to do with what happened in the Middle East now.
Okay, I'm Madawi Al-Rashid, professor of anthropology at King's College and also historian. When I was called to be told about the film, I must confess that of my ignorance. As someone who spends most of his time reading books and writing books, I am very shallow in my knowledge about drama and serials in the Arab world, and I admitted that I was ignorant about your programs, and I didn't know anything about the serials that you have done. Since I heard your name, I Googled you, and I found quite a lot, and I was very impressed. But I still to see this film and other serials that you have done. And also it came to my attention that you have actually worked for the Saudis and produced some programs for them. So anybody who would accuse the Al Rashid of sponsorship of this project, I think I have answered the question for them. But my question to you is, in the publicity for the film, the Al Rashid name comes quite frequently. But as a historian, I have actually covered the history of Saudi Arabia. And the Al-Rashids were not the only people who were at the receiving end of the brutality of Ibn Saud. And I yet to see how you project that moment in 1921 when his troops first accused the Al-Rashid and the people of Hayl of being blasphemous, very much like what the jihadis and the Saudi religious establishment does today with all its opponents. They accuse them of being kafir, and those Arabs who are here would know exactly what I mean. Kafir means a blasphemous person, and therefore his blood and his property are halal to slaughter and confiscate. So the Al-Rashid and the region were not the only region, and we here can talk about earlier than 1921. For example, when the Saudi troops moved to Al-Hasa in the Shia area, then they moved to Al-Hijaz, and Al-Hijaz, the cradle of Islam, its population was accused of being infidels, Sufis and grave worshippers, and there was a massacre in Taif in 1925. Again, the same story, we see it among the people in Najd itself, when Ibn Saud troops moved into mosques, slaughtered people in mosques, in a complete treachery. So I would like to know whether this King of the Sand covers multiple regions in Saudi Arabia, and it's not simply about the Al-Rashid and Al-Saud, because Al-Rashid were just one group among many, many others.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Very important question. As I don't know, you have a copy of the script or?
I'm Rima Chervi from Press TV. I'd like to ask you, what are you willing to achieve through screening this film worldwide, or what is your message from it?
تشابه الفترة الماضية أحداث الفيلم مع تشابه ما يحدث اليوم في منطقتنا العربية من تقسيم جديد وإعادة رسم الخارطة العربية هو اللي دعاني أنا أفكر ملياً بإنتاج هذا الفيلم. الأمة العربية بحاجة الآن إلى وقف مع الذات، إلى نقد صريح وواضح، إلى إعادة صياغة وتشكيل المجتمع من جديد، والتخلص من كل الدكتاتورية اللي موجودة في العالم العربي، على الأقل في المرحلة الحالية أن نسمع الآخر والآخر يسمعنا، نستطيع أن نتحاور. وأنا أفضل وسيلة شفتها هي الفن، لأن من خلال الفن فينا نوصل رسائل عديدة ورسائل مهمة، خاصة أنه هذا الفيلم العمل باللغة الإنجليزية وليس باللغة العربية لحتى يوصل للعالم أكثر، لأنه لو الفيلم أنتج في العالم العربي يستطيعون وأد هذا الفيلم بثواني يعني، ولا يصل إلى أي محطة، لأنه معظمكم بيعرف المحطات مين بيملكها وهي صاحبة القرار في العرض، وبالتالي رؤوس الأموال تستطيع أن تلعب دور كبير وتخفي هذا العمل أو تسيئله أو تمنع عرضه على الأقل. فخروجنا إلى الغرب هو نوع من الاستنجاد بشيء يمكن أن يفيد واقعنا، ممكن أنه هذه الصورة تأثر أكثر، ممكن هذا الشيء يردع الطرف الآخر بأن يستمع إلى وجهة النظر الأخرى. نحن هنا في هذا الفيلم لسنا ضد الشعب السعودي على الإطلاق، كلهم إخواننا وأحبائنا ونحن أشقاء ونحن بلد واحد، ما في فرق إطلاقا. أنا مو فقط سوري، أنا عربي، أنا دائما بقول أنا مخرج عربي سوري. فأنا يعني سعيد أني قدرت أعمل هاي التجربة إلى حد الآن، ما بنعرف إن شاء الله شو ممكن يكون صداها على المدى البعيد، هل ممكن ينجح الفيلم أو ما ينجح، لكن لنا شرف المحاولة أن استطعنا أنه ننتج هذا الفيلم بإمكانياتنا الستاندرد الإنتاج الأوروبي اللي نستطيع ننافس فيه وما نخجل من عرضه في أي مهرجان عالمي كما سيحدث في الأشهر القادمة إن شاء الله. شكرا.
My name is Ahmed Kamel. I'm a student of sociology and politics at Goldsmiths College. Eyal Sivan, the Israeli filmmaker, makes it a point that all his documentaries are centered around perhaps excavating the truth about what happened in 1948 due to the emancipatory potential of memory, an accurate memory, not polemic or dogmatic memory. Do you feel that this film is perhaps the beginning of such of the same effect in Saudi Arabia to try and counteract the distorted memory of the initiation of the country, and do you think it can have perhaps what could be those, or release the, realize that emancipatory potential of accurate memory?
نحن ضد كل الجرائم اللي ترتكب بحق الشعوب أينما كان، مسلم ولا يهودي ولا مسيحي. نحن كفنانين أولا نرفض تماما أي عنف يمارس ضد أي إنسان مدني، ونحن نشجع دائما على إنتاج هذه الأفلام التي تكشف وتعري هذه المجازر التي حصلت في التاريخ، وخصوصا في التاريخ الذي التابو اللي ما بنقدر نقرب عليه وما بنقدر نحكي عنه. الآن أصبح الوقت مناسب للحديث عن هذا الشيء، العالم الآن يعني أصبح في متناول الجميع، نستطيع أن نوصل صوتنا إلى كل مكان في العالم.
أنور كوادري، فيلم دايركتور وبروديوسر. I salute you because I passed the same experience myself when I made my feature film of Jamal Abdel Nasser back in 1998. And you, like you, I put all my money and everything else, and it was a big gamble. So I understand how you feel now. Let's talk about the film, which I would love to have seen it tonight. When is going to be ready? Have you finished? Have you got a finished film that we can see very soon? Have you got a release date for it? What are the campaign plans? Are you going to start, for example, with UK release or Italy, because you have an Italian star, or British stars you have with you also. What sort of plans you have for this film, because very important. I just realized that we haven't got a scriptwriter name on the or director of photography or the editors. Well, can you please also tell us who you used on the technical matters, because I think many people would like to know who you used on your technical star, because I know you pick very well. Who did the music for you? Where did you do the post-production? Just give us, let's talk about the film more than politics, because we are here to see, to talk about the film rather than just the politics. And I know you are a good filmmaker, and you like to talk on the side that you are very good at.
End of May, we'll release the film worldwide, and we'll start also participate in a different film festival, around 24 now booked already. Except the Arab world, of course, I mean, you know. Some people, they don't want to put their names on the film. You know the reason. Oh. So.
You have, by the way, you've got the cast list in the
And folder. We have the, in the folder the cast list.
What
also.
What location? Where did you shoot the film?
Everywhere.
Good evening. Hi, Hugh Miles. I'm a journalist. I'm disappointed not to see that the whole film this evening. Really looking forward to it. I wonder how historically accurate the film is and what steps you took to try and make it as accurate as it could be. And also, if you could tell us anything about the taboos which it breaks, then that would be very interesting. Thank you.
هناك الكثير من الأحداث التي حدثت في التاريخ قيام المملكة العربية السعودية استدعت دراسة عميقة جدا لكي نستطيع أن نعكسها بشكل درامي على الشاشة. لا يمكن تغطي التاريخ كبير مثل هذا التاريخ والمثير والمشوق والذي تزامن مع أحداث كثيرة في المنطقة أيضا أن نغطيها من خلال ساعتين إلى ربع في فيلم سينمائي. ولكن حاولنا نحن نأخذ أهم النقاط الأساسية في مسيرة هذه الشخصية منذ أن أتى من منفاه في الكويت إلى أن أصبح ملك على المملكة العربية السعودية وكيف تم تسمية المملكة العربية السعودية وكل المجازر التي حدثت في تلك الفترة وركزنا فيها على أهم النقاط مثل ما تفضلت الدكتورة أيضا استطعنا من خلال الفيلم أن نعمل توليفة درامية توثيقية إلى حد ما ولكي نكون منصفين أيضا يعني يقبل وجهة النظر يعني ما ممكن نقول أن كل شيء حقيقي لأنه أيضا التاريخ اللي مكتوب ما كله حقيقي يعني لكن احنا استندنا قدر الامكان الى اكثر من مصدر لكي نوثق الحادثه اللي نحن بنحكي عنها بالفيلم واعتقد انه الفيلم جريء ويمكن ان يخيف بعض الناس من هون بنقول انه في تابو انه في ناس بيحاولوا يخفوا تاريخهم ما يحكوا عنه خلينا ناخذ مثل الان احنا بنشوف الاوروبيين في اتحاد اوروبي ولكن في هناك افلام ضد النازيه وافلام ضد المعتقلات اللي صارت افلام ضد الثورات اللي صارت أفلام مع الثورات اللي صارت فهناك في نقد دائما في مجتمع عم يفرز ويقدم وجهات نظر مختلفة وعلى الجميع أن يراها أو يسمعها ويناقش فيها يقبلها أو يرفضها ونحن من هذا المنطلق قدمنا وجهة نظر ممكن أن تعجب ناس كثيرين وممكن لا تعجب ناس كثيرين ولكن نحن على الأقل كنا أول المحاولين بجرأة أنه نطرق لموضوع شائك موضوع لا يمكن البحث فيه ممنوع الرفض رفض قاطع أنه نتقرب على أي شيء بمثل المملكة العربية السعودية بهذا الإطار وهذا لا يتوقف فقط عن المملكة العربية السعودية في كثير من البلدان العربية أيضا بتشارك بنفس الإحساس
صلاح البندر is Cambridge based scholar activist I'm very impressed by what we have seen here in very short period of time But what has really troubled me all the time when we discuss about all these issues is trying to marginalize some parts of the figures which played some role. In my scholarship interest, I'm very much interested in the role of the Africans of Arabia. And from what I've read and from what I've seen and from what I'm really doing for the last 16 years is trying to rediscover again that major lieutenants and participants in this, especially in conquering Riyadh city or town of the day, is from African Arabian origins. I didn't see one single black face in your trailer.
Not and, in the trailer, but in the film.
Well, we haven't seen it in the trailer.
We have many.
Well, if you have many, I would really like to see them in the trailer next time.
Okay.
Thank you. My name is Carol Kerst. I'm presently a colleague of Madawi al-Rashid at King's College, but also a former resident of Saudi Arabia. talking about indeed parties involved in building Saudi Arabia, I can understand that for any English language film you feature a figure like Philby. But what about all the Arab advisors, Rashad Farao and Hafiz Wahba? If he had made it in Arabic, would they have had a more prominent place?
We have, but you have to see all the film. So I can't answer all the questions now because it's unlogically. So, but we have many.
أستاذ أنزور المثقف والفنان العربي خلال 50 عام كان شريك في السلطة وفي تلميع صورة السلطة. الثورات العربية بدأت بطريقة أنها أسقطت الرموز، وهذا إسقاط الرموز حصل عن طريق الفن وعن طريق الكتابة التاريخية وعن طريق الإنترنت وعن طريق الشارع والميدان. هل تعتقد أو برأيك أنه فيلمك هذا سيؤدي إلى المزيد من إنتاجات فنية تحطم الرموز، وليس فقط تحطمها، تعيد صياغتها حتى نعرف أن الرمز ليس إله وإنما له وجهان، وجه الإيجابي والوجه السلبي؟ كتبنا التاريخية مليئة بالوجه الإيجابي وتلميع الصورة، فهل اللحظة اليوم مناسبة لإعادة صياغة هذا التاريخ حتى نستطيع أن ننتقل من هذا التاريخ إلى المستقبل؟ السؤال الثاني هو اللي عبد الله فيلبي. I would like to ask you if we have actually come to that moment as a result of the Arab Spring. The other question is we have seen one woman in the bedroom in your film. And as a woman, I would like to see myself elsewhere. Women have actually, in addition to the bedroom, women have played an important role in the history of Arabia and the history of all Arab countries. So far, everybody has ignored them. And in Ibn Saud's narrative, the only woman we know of is Noura, his sister, because when he used to fight, he would claim her name and he says, Akhu Noura, and go and slaughter some people. And therefore, are women in your film portrayed outside the bedroom? What I would like to ask you is, did it feel different when you converted to Islam? And what did you have to learn the way in your manners and the way you handled yourself as an actor playing Abdullah Filbi?
Myself as an actor, you get given a part. And for myself, politically, it's a historical piece. So I portrayed Filbi, that was on the screen. When he became Muslim, which I thought was fascinating because I've read his book, we didn't show much of that afterwards. So no, I didn't particularly act that much different in the film. What was fascinating about what I read about him was that how he was very pro-Arab because of the broken promises he felt that Britain was making to the Arab world, which I thought was very admirable and stuff. And yes, I don't think, I'm not too sure I did act that different, really. I didn't have to, there wasn't required in the script after that, really, to be honest with you. So I didn't act that different, no. It was a fascinating character play, I must admit,
Okay, thank you.
Go back to the... I can sure there is another woman in there, but not in the... outside the bedroom, and also, this is just for the trailer, and you know the trailers. This is a flavors only for the trailer.
Although so I must admit, we
mentioned many wives, many, you know, in his life, so we have a lot.
Haifa Al-Hababi, I'm a PhD student at SOAS. My question is, may I know what's the period for that film? It's from which year to which year?
It covers 50 years.
Before and after, or?
Yeah. Until we reached the moment they announced about the kingdom.
Okay, it's only about King Abdulaziz.
From Kuwait and then,
So it's only about King
Abdulaziz. Not all of it, just part of it, because we have two lines. Abdulaziz, when he was old, he remembered the lighting moment of his trip.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Rebecca Giles, and I'm a supporter of the arts Bridging Gaps. I'm interested to know the reason why you chose to portray Arab leads using non-Arab actors. And I'm also interested to know if, from a Western perspective, it's very interesting to see how the film, only judging from the trailer, is It seems very Western. It seems like it has all of the different formulaic aspects. It has the fight scene, it has the girl, it has all of these things. How is it sensationalist from a non-Arab perspective?
First of all, just to add, even before he starts, you've got the cast list there, and there are actually actors from Lebanon, Syria, Turkey, Britain, and Italy. Mr. Azoul said that he, first of all, chose a British actor to act the British role, Philby himself, and an Italian actor because of the accent.
It's Fida Basile from BBC. يعني بالعالم العربي دائما في نظرية المؤامرة. سمو الأميرة سألتك ليش هلا تم إطلاق الفيلم؟ أنا عم بسألك ليش هلا الفيلم أو ليش الفيلم على المملكة العربية السعودية؟ يعني البعض بيعتبر إنه حضرتك سوري وكمان التاريخ السوري مش ما كان دائما مضيء، فليش ما سلطت الضوء على التاريخ السوري؟ وبالنسبة للممثلين الحاضرين معنا تعامل مع مخرج عربي شو بتفرق؟
أنا شخصية الملك عبد العزيز يعني استفزتني وأنا عم بقرأ تاريخ الشخصية وشوف في لمحات كتير مهمة ومضيئة بإمكان الفنان إنه يستفيد منها ويقدم عمل مميز وهذا العمل حتى اللي يمكن الوهلة الأولى مثل ما تفضلت الأخت الصحفية قالت إنه ممكن يكون ويسترن شوي الستايل تبعه أو شيء بس هذا من ضرورات المهنة يعني حتى تدخلي السوق الأوروبية تدخلي السوق الأمريكية تريد تقدمي العمل لازم يكون الكواليتي تبعه عالي التكنيك المستخدم تكنيك مهم لكن بنفس الوقت الأسلوبية تبع العمل كان كتير إلى خصوصية ويمكن ما في فيلم بيشبه هذا الفيلم بكل العالم العربي لحد هلا يعني العمل الموضوع ما شرط أني أكون سوري ممكن أكون أنا جنسيتي غير جنسية بس الفكرة ما لها علاقة بسوريا الفكرة لها علاقة تحديدا بهي الشخصية وتشابه ما يحدث اليوم مع ما حدث بالأمس من تقسيم يعني إذا نرجع لاتفاقية سايكس بيكو بنشوف كيف العالم العربي تقسم بنشوف اليوم نفس الشيء عم بصير بتسميات مختلفة يعني هذا الشيء اللي استفزني بالموضوع والشيء الثاني إنه دائما هن حاطين هيك مثل جلالة يعني مقدسة ممنوع حدا يقرب على هذا المكان أنا بشوف إنه كل الناس فيها تقرب وفيها تكشف المستور وفيها تحكي وما في شيء نخاف منه ليش عم اذا في شيء سيء عاملينه هن عم يخبوه خلينا نشوفه شو هو ونحكم عليه اليوم ممكن كان هذا لضرورات ينعمل ممكن كان هذا الشيء مهم بهذيك الفتره انه ينعمل ممكن لا بس احنا لازم نعرف والعالم من حقهم انهم يعرفوا انه هذا التاريخ ما بصير يضل مخبى حتى التاريخ السوري لو اي حدا اجى اليوم بده يعمل فيلم عن تاريخ سوريا او عن حافظ الاسد ما راح نمنعه ما راح نقول له لا تعمل الفيلم وأنا مستعد أعمل عنه وعن غيره ما عندي مشكلة إذا الموضوع استفزني إذا حسيت إنه الآن الوقت المناسب له بكل صراحة.
About the other part of the question. How is it to work with an Arab film director?
Well, there's no difference. I mean, art and film is international, and we all speak the same language. And it was wonderful work with Najdat. The only thing was with Najdat, he would constantly forget my name was Bill and called me John all the way through. John, please do this. Okay, and in the end I gave up. I thought, yes, I am John Philby. I will be John Philby. But no, it was wonderful to work with Najdat. I'd love to work with more directors from all around the world. I'd love to work with Brazilians and Russians. It'd be fantastic. I think it brings us all together. And that's what art does and filmmaking does. And it was a wonderful experience. And I hope we do another one.
Did he ever call you Abdullah after you
I think he might have once, actually. Maybe, but there was,
it was
John. It was John, yeah, all the way through, John.
So different experience, one movie, another movie, we change the world, we change the country, we change the role. And anyway, it's a new incontro, it's a new meeting. And it was very, very good, this meeting and then ahead, because to act is not normal, it's something out of our normal life. If they pay you, you can act if you want, but if you want to really have the truth when you act, you have to make a relationship between an actor and the director. It's a kind of a relationship that looks like love. And I had this relationship with this fantastic director, and I say thank you very much because I think then I did what he wants, then I have to do it.
Let's be a little bit critical. I heard, and he's not hearing, that he is quite snappy, sharp, and moody.
Not at all. Not at all.
Yes, he is.
No. Not at all. I have a different role. It was different with me.
It's lovely.
Hang on a minute. Italy, I'm written. 1 second, please. No, John. Sorry, Abdullah. Please.
I think sometimes that was his manner. He would snap and, oh, please, don't want go. You know, he would. But he wasn't. He was never horrible about it. But yes, he did. He did shout. Not a horrible way. But I did hear him shout. Not at me, but I heard him shout at other people. And for all I know, he might be saying some terrible things about me in Arabic. I have no idea. But hopefully, it was. I mean, I'd also as well, I'd make a point. I don't know what was very interesting when Najdat asked me to be in it. I saw the book of John Philby. There's a book called Philby of Arabia, which I read. And on the front cover of the book, you see Philby dressed in Arabic garb, clothes. And even my own son, who saw the book recently, a 13-year-old, said to me, Dad, is that you? And it absolutely, incredibly, does look like me. So I might be a terrible actor, but at least I look like him.
It's really true. It's some magic, some magician. I had the photo in front of the mirror, remember? The big photo of the king, and the makeup man try every morning, stay a couple of hours to do, and to make myself, to arrive to have the similar image. And I was looking for two hours, every morning to see this face. And my muscles and the handling, they move exactly with this kind of smile that he have, very interesting. And I feel good for a long day after. Really, it's something magician, then you arrive and you want to do this kind of face and expressive, and we arrive. It's something really magical. And always, thanks to the director, of course. Oh.
Thank you. Thank you. You want to work again with him, don't you?
Najdat, أنت مخرج كبير ومعروف بأفلامك ومسلسلاتك الجريئة جدا اللي مو متعود عليها المجتمع العربي. وأكيد أنت بهذا الفيلم حطيت بذهنك تحديات اللي بدك تواجهها بالمستقبل. إذا عرض هذا الفيلم بأكثر من مكان حتى بالدول الأوروبية. إذا موريس ضغط عليك على هذا الفيلم لإيقافه، هل مستعد إيقاف الفيلم ولا بتتحدى وبتكمل عرض الفيلم؟
أنا بجيب لك مثل صغير بقول إنه اللي بيخاف كتير جبان، واللي ما بيخاف مجنون. فأنا لا لي جبان ولا لي مجنون. يعني أنا بعرف خطورة الموضوع، ومن اللحظة الأولى بعرف إنه ممكن يصير في أشياء كتيرة، لكن أنا مؤمن تماما بإنه نحن لازم نحكي. ونبلش نحكي من هاي اللحظة وما نخاف من أي شيء، ما عاد في شيء يخوف، العالم مفتوح وبإمكاننا الآن نوصل أصواتنا، حتى لو منعوا الفيلم يعني فينا نحطه بالإنترنت يعني ببساطة بينشاف يعني، وكل ما منعوه كل ما صار مرغوب أكثر إنه ينشاف الفيلم.
You know, I think an actor is an artist. The art is outside of the political problem. The world for us is one. And I will lie everybody all together, you know, kind of things up of the political problem. We are in the political, of course, because we have the country, we have the language, we have a rule, but the arts, creative men like us, I think we are out of this kind of problem, we are up. And we are, you know, Leonardo da Vinci, he was painting with the Pope and the King, and always esclave to the power, of course, but because they need the power to do something, because if we don't have the producer, we can work. Yeah. You know, a painting need only a pencil and piece of paper, but we need a troop and a lot of money to our art, you know, to get out of our art. And that's the reason, because a lot of art actors and actors take this political and this on the other. But for me personally, I'm out, completely out of the, if I love a project, I'll do, that's all.
But did you yourself personally receive threats or any documents or leak or letters or?
Of course I did, I had. Yes. No. Just when we finished the movie, I had a lot of email, and they want to press me to ask me. They want to know something.
Who?
Who knows? I don't know. I don't know really.
No, I mean lawyers or
yes, lawyer, and they have me a lot of international rules. You have to do this. You have to do this. You have to do this. And the ending after 2 weeks, I say, bullshit. Do what you want. I'm an actor. That's all.
ما زال حضرتك بتقول انه استفزتك الشخصيه وبتحبها وحبيت تعملها موفي لو كنت حكيت مع الاميديت فاميلي تبعوله
ليه
حتى تاخذ their side to see if you can cover anything missing anything لانه البوكس والهيك يعني قايتر حضرتك او السكريبت رايتر يعني بما انه
سؤالك حلو
متكل بس على البوكس في people still alive يعني يمكن كانوا يحبوا هن في اشياء
شوف حتى نبعد عن الدوافع الشخصيه لكل شخص ممكن يحكي اللي بده اياه هلا الكتب موجوده بوجهات نظر مختلفه في عرب في مستشرقين في ناس مع في ناس ضد يعني اذا بتقري ليست طويله الشخصيه عامه مالي مضطر ارجع للعائله واسال هذا شخصيه ملك للجميع مثله مثل اي زعيم عربي مثل اي زعيم عالمي مثل اي شخصيه عالميه فهو من حق الجميع
No, I'm not saying permission, I'm saying to cover more areas of his life. I'm not sure they can cover the right area.
Why not? Why not? Why do you think they will not tell the truth? Is it because simply, actually, they are traded?
We don't have references like you.
You should have
thought of me. I don't know that before.
You should have thought of me. I would have told you the truth.
If I meet you before that, maybe. I don't know.
لينا مشربش من البي بي سي العربية. أول شيء بحييك أستاذ نجدت على أعمالك السابقة والجاي والمستقبل إن شاء الله أنت اسم لامع ونتمنى دائما أنك تكون في الأسماء من ضمن الأسماء العالمية لكن سؤال بسيط وهو لاحظت أنه أنت طبعا بأعمالك السابقة كان في مشاركات من فنانين عرب ليش المرة هاي بس سوريين ولبنانيين
صعب انه كانوا يقبلوا ويشتغلوا نجوم كبار معروفين بالعالم العربي لانه في حساسيه بالموضوع بتعرفي انت مستقبلهم كله بيتوقف على مشاركتهم او عدم مشاركتهم هاي ممكن تاثر على مستقبلهم المهني خصوصا انه معظم المحطات العربيه تملكها يعني اموال خليجيه او اموال سعوديه فبينقطع رزقهم يعني بالعربي
Yeah, you spoke of a global release. Is there going to be a release inside Saudi Arabia, any kind of event? And when? And what kind of reaction do you anticipate, both from the authorities and from the people there? Thank you.
Authorities are just legal now, until this moment. Just a few letters from the government through their lawyer. And this distribution in Saudi Arabia impossible because they don't have theaters also. Internet release free. We have to collect the money first.
As you can see, he's not quite 24, and he has actually invested all his money into this production. So it's quite a challenging. Not to say that you don't look young, of course, and you too, Mr. Philby. Well, on your behalf, I'd like to thank Mr. Fabio Testi, Mr. Abdullah,
George, George,
fellows, George, and Mr. Anzour.